Hi there, welcome to Chief Tested. This is my new site, my new hobby that I want to do. I've got 25 years in the fire service, and today we're going to be talking about some fire gloves. Noticed online that there really aren't a whole lot of firefighter reviews of certain small products that firefighters may buy, so hopefully this will give you guys an idea of what's out there. And you know, I'm not being endorsed by anybody. I'm not being sent anything. This is all paid out of my own pocket. So let's get on with it. Okay, thanks for watching. Okay, the item today is going to be the ProTec 8 Fusion Glove. These are rated for firefighting, for wildland and structural, as well as extrication. They are 1971 NFPA compliant. They do have a mesh inside that will protect you from bloodborne pathogens and liquids. The outer part is a blended goatskin suede. First impressions of these, I do like them. They look pretty sturdy. They're dark. I prefer dark colored gloves. They don't show as much stains. That's just my opinion though. They've got some pretty good reinforced stitching. Putting them on is fairly simple. They're not hard to get on at all, even when they're brand new. I've been using these for a couple weeks now, primarily doing a bunch of shoveling snow and all that. General impressions feeling them, they are great. They do fit nicely. They're snug. They don't seem to be too tight. I can touch pinky and thumb. Okay, some of the things that I'm going to be reviewing are going to be going over some aspects of it for grip, durability, as well as fine motor skills with them. First thing for grip, using one of my rescue wrenches, which will be in a later video to review, which I do like. For gripping, it's got a good grip on it, so it also can simulate if you're grabbing onto the handrail of an engine, getting in or out. It's got a good grip. It doesn't feel too tight, doesn't feel like it's binding up on your fingers or around the joints at all, and the knuckles. And open them up with ease. Second thing is going to be for doing fine motor coordination. I can easily pick up a pen and to show what it would look like if you need to write with the pen. It already feels kind of bulky, but if you needed to write on a form while you're in the field, it does write fairly good. It does feel a little bulky, but not too bad for being a structural glove. I've dealt with a lot worse gloves out there. As you can see, it's not too bad. It is still legible. Another fine motor coordination test. Using a small Carmex, I can easily open it up. So for anything you have to twist on and off, fairly easy. Dealing with small tools, a pair of channel locks that you may have in your bunker gear, I recommend everybody have a pair of tools in their pocket. It's very easy. I can open them up, I can close, I can do the fine adjustments, as well as for opening and closing with one hand. Okay, pricing on these, depending on where you look at, I got these from the fire store. These can range anywhere from about $50 to $60. I have noticed that smaller gloves are tending to cost a little bit more. Normally you would see that in the larger gloves, larger gear, it costs a little bit more, but they seem to be adding extra price for smaller gear. My wife, who is also a retired volunteer firefighter, I know she's pretty upset about that, you know, targeting the smaller brothers and sisters out there, that it's not fair that they're jacking the price on them. However, you can search around, see what deals are out there, what sales. I got these on sale when they're, you know, before I got them, so they're not too bad. Again, these are about $50 to $60. I'm going to be doing another set of gloves from ProTech 8, their Evolution, in another video. I'm going to be getting that ready as well. Here we're running the water over the glove for 5 minutes to see exactly how much water will get into the glove and make it completely soaked through. This is to replicate either foul weather or active firefighting with the hose.
Okay. That's not wet.
Not okay. Wet. Thumb. Not wet. Pinky. Not wet. Middle finger.
That one looked up.
Oh. Not wet. Forefinger. Not wet. And it's not wet in there. It's cold, but it's not wet. And
can't bring this one more.
Now with the wet glove, we'll go ahead and place it into the freezer for 1 hour to simulate freezing conditions.
Pull it out. Tap the table. Tell them how it feels. Say how it feels.
Right now it's very cold. Obviously, it's been in the freezer for an hour. It's very, very stiff and rigid. The fingers are still frozen. While it's still frozen, I am able to start getting more dexterity and movement with it. doesn't feel wet inside. It feels really cold though. But I'm not feeling any wetness. See, my hand is dry. I'm gonna keep my hand in it a little bit more and see if I start feeling it get wet. Right now, the only hand that's wet is my ungloved hand. Glove is almost to full maneuverability and stuff with gripping. I can easily pick up small items. Okay, so the next review I'm going to do on the ProTech 8 Fusion structural glove is for puncturability and cut resistance. Show you that for this knife it is sharp. Cuts very easily. I'm going to be using this foam padding to show you what it'll look like. This one I'm going to be cutting so you can see clearly what it looks like.
No, you need to see a puncture.
Okay, so the cuts and the punctures, as you can see clearly on it. I'm going to place this one in a finger. And the glove and the thumb. This one's going to be in the palm. As you can see, there is a cut. There's a small little puncture in the palm, but there's no cut in the palm part. For the cut on the glove, you can see there's no slice on the glove where it was right there. You can see the Kevlar lining. So, on a close-up view, you do have the one cut there, but the Kevlar is still intact. And then in the palm, you can see right there where there's a couple little cuts and you can just start to see where the Kevlar is underneath. You can see just right there. And this is where the puncture was. So overall it did do its job in preventing any cuts to the person wearing it. So I've marked where the two little punctures were when we did the stabbing and the cutting on your palm. I'm going to put this back in and we're going to do a cut and a stab on the top part right here. Looking at it, you can see where the one puncture was right there. I'm not seeing any cuts at all, exposing the outer portion. Pull out to see, there's one little puncture mark right there, but there's no cuts whatsoever. The puncture mark right here that was done is a lot less in depth than the two over here that were in the palm. So you have the two little puncture marks right there, and then the new one right there. And again, there's no cuts whatsoever. So, in conclusion for the cut resistance, the glove does very well for cut resistance. It will cut the outer layer, but it will not go through the Kevlar, which is good. However, with the puncture resistance that you saw, we had three small punctures that we got out of our testing. So this tells me that with the three puncture marks, that you could potentially get punctured by a sharp object, the needle or whatnot. So you need to be aware of that. So in conclusion, for the Pro-Tech 8 Fusion gloves, again, they are between $50 to $60 range. They are NFPA 1971 compliant, as well as having a bloodborne pathogen barrier inside it. They are rated for structural, wildland, and extrication. The water test showed that after being soaked for 5 minutes, they were dry on the inside. And in the freezing test, even though it was frozen rock solid, it was still dry on the inside and was able to retain its shape and dexterity fairly quickly. Okay, for the cut and puncture test, it did cut again right there on the outer edge, but the Kevlar was still intact, as well as the small micro cuts that you saw on the palm and the puncture wounds of where we had the small puncture holes, but there was no cuts. With this, I do find it to be a good glove. It will protect you from sharp objects. However, punctures can still happen. It's puncture and cut resistant, not proof. So remember that. On a rating of 1 to 5, being chief tested, I'm going to give out between 1 and 5 helmets, with one helmet being your standard everyday blue glove that everybody gets. I would give this a total of 3.5 helmets. It's not the best glove out there, I'm sure, but it's definitely not the worst. I would recommend, if you wanted to buy a set of gloves, that these are a good pair of gloves to get. And stay tuned for more reviews that I'll do. Thank you. Stay safe out there.